Hi, it's Tammy, and today we're looking at IV therapy. Specifically, we're going to be looking at how to calculate an infusion rate when we are given a volume and a time. And the second thing is looking at our drip rate when we do not have a pump and we need to hang by gravity. Before we get started, there's a few things I just want to touch on. First is dimensional analysis. That's a problem-solving tool I like to use, and if you're not familiar with it, you can click on the link that's popping up and take that tutorial first and then come back and join us. Second, there are two free quizzes in the description box. You know where to find them. Download those and take advantage of that self-assessment piece. And third, subscribe and make sure you leave me a comment to let me know how these videos help you. So we're going to start with drip factors, and I'm going to see you at the board. Before we start, I just want to review the drawing on the right-hand side of the page. We're looking at the difference between macro and micro drips. In the macro lines, the drops are larger, which means it takes fewer to make 1 mil. Here's where you're going to find your 10 drops, 15 drops, or 20 drop per mil lines. In a micro drip, you can see that the drops are smaller, and it takes more drops to make 1 mil. This is where we find the 60 drop per mil line. We control the rate of the fluid by the roller clamp, moving it up and down to get the rate just where we want it. Now with that, we can start our first question. We have an order for 250 mL of D5W over 2 hours. The drip factor is 15 drops per mil, and we want to know how many drops per minute. So the first thing I want to know is, what do I need to solve for? And that's drops per minute. Next, I'm going to put in, what do I know already? Well, I know that this line takes 15 drops to make 1 mil, and I want to get rid of mils and convert this to minutes. And so I look and I see I have 250 mils in 2 hours, and I still need to convert those hours to minutes, so I'm going to put in my conversion. And now I have isolated my drops per minute, and I can solve this equation. So 15 drops times by 250 times by 1 divided by 2 times 60 minutes. If I bring out my calculator, do the calculation quickly, it is 3750 drops divided by 120 minutes. Further this out, and you can see that the answer is 31.25 drops per minute. However, we always round up or down to the nearest number. So this will be 31 drops per minute. Okay, here we have another order. 250 mils over 1 hour, and I have an IV set that has 60 drops per mil, and I'm looking for drops per minute. So as always, what is the question asking me to find? And I'm going to start with that, drops per minute. Then I need to identify the key information. So what do I know? I know that I have a tube that it takes 60 drops to make 1 mil. I also know that I have an order of 250 mils over 1 hour. And that will allow me to cross off the mils. Remember, these are not fractions, but these are relationships. And then I have to do a conversion. I know that in 1 hour, there are 60 minutes. This will allow me to cross off the hours. And then you can see now I have isolated my drops in the numerator and my minutes in the denominator, and I can go ahead and solve this equation. So on the numerator, I have 60 drops times by 250 times by 1. And in the denominator, I have 1 times 1 times 60 minutes. Pull up my calculator, and you can see that this is 15,000 drops divided by 60 minutes. Further calculate this out, and the answer is 250 drops per minute. Now we could go back a step where we had our 60 drops times by 250 divided by 60 minutes. The 60s would cross off, leaving us with simply 250 drops per minute. That's another way to solve. Okay, one final example. Patients receiving 460 mL of blood over 4 hours, and our drip rate is 20 drips per mil. So what are we looking for now? We want to know how many drips per minute. I know I have 20 drops per mil, so I put that into my equation. I want to cancel out mils. So again, the relationship is 416 mils over 4 hours. I again want to get rid of hours, and I'm going to put in my conversion of 1 hour is 60 minutes. Then I have isolated my drops and my minutes, and I can solve this equation. So I'm going to carry on with the factoring out here. 20 drops times 416 times by 1 divided by 1 times 4 times 60. Pull up the calculator. And you can see 20 times 416 is 8,320 drops. And I'm going to divide that by 240 minutes. I'll put my units back up here. Furthering this calculation, you can see that the final answer is 34.66 drops per minute. Again, we want to round to the nearest whole number, so this would be 35 drops per minute. Okay, we're now more at the word problems for infusion-based questions. In this question, I'm looking for an hourly rate of an infusion, mils per hour. I can see that over 24 hours, I have a fluid balance of minus 640, and it's been ordered as a replacement of 1:1 with normal saline over 4 hours. So when I plunk in my 640 over 4 hours, I can immediately solve this equation. 640 divided by 4 is equal to 160 mils per hour. All right, in this question, we need to be careful and watch out for information that we don't need. So I always start out with, what do I need to know? In my last sentence, what is the infusion rate in mils per hour? So I'm looking for volume over time. Now, when I go read the question, there's a lot of information in here. I have solucortef 50 milligrams diluted in a 100 ml bag of normal saline. My patient has a 22 gauge cathalon that will infuse over 15 minutes. And the IV drip factor is 10 drops per mil. So there's a lot of things to look at. What I'm specifically curious about is the 100 mils over 15 minutes. So I'm going to put that into my equation. I'm looking for mils per hour though. 15 minutes needs a conversion into hours. So I know from my conversion table that there are 60 minutes in 1 hour. So I'm going to add that to my equation. I now have my units of mils per hour isolated and I can solve. So 100 mils times 60 divided by 15 hours. Pull up the calculator and you'll see that this is 6,000 mils divided by 15 hours. And let's further finish this off, and it is 400 mils per hour. In another way to write this, 100 mils times by 60 over 15, 15 goes into 60 four times, so I can get rid of the 15, and it's simply 100 times 4, which equals 400 mils per hour. And we've made it to our last question of this practice. ANCEF 1 gram is to be infused 1 hour prior to OR. It is diluted in 100 mils of normal saline and to go over 30 minutes. What is the infusion rate? Again, I'm looking for volume over time, mils per hour. So I go back to my question, what do I have in there that would satisfy this equation? I have 100 mils over 30 minutes. Just like our last question, I need to convert minutes to hours, so I know that there are 60 minutes in every hour. I'm going to add this into my conversion and cross off my minutes, and I'll be able to solve. So this leaves us 100 mils times 60 divided by 30 times 1 hour. Bringing up the calculator, you can see this is 6,000 mils divided by 30 hours. And completing this calculation, this rounds out to 200 mils per hour. Fantastic. There you have it. We've completed our infusion calculations and our drip rate calculations. Don't forget those free quizzes to help you with your self-assessment. Comment below, let me know how this went for you, and subscribe. There'll be new videos coming out regularly. Until next time, take care.